Good morning and welcome to worship on April 18th, 2021. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. If you're looking for a church family or you'd like to join our church, please contact me, Pastor Chris, by phone or email. I'd love to talk to you. We'll be worshiping online and by phone this week and next week, April 25th. And then on May 2nd, we'll start worship in the Grove outside again at 10:30, and services will also be posted online and on phone. You do not need to sign up for those services once we start outdoor worship, and you can look and find the information through all of our ways that we communicate. So let's love and serve God now through our worship.
The Easter season, the season of new life and a breath of the Spirit. As we enter this time of worship together, may we open our hearts to the renewal of our minds and our spirits. May we dare to let go and dance with renewed vigor as we allow resurrection hope to fill our bodies and souls.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their story, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
This week, we acknowledge that sometimes we are unsure about our steps in this world. For the disciples, even while in their joy at seeing Jesus after the resurrection, they were still disbelieving and wondering. We are reminded that even though we may not know our next steps, we can be sure they will come because we are God's beloved children, and so we have steps to follow. Those of the resurrected Jesus.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their story, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
This is the call. Face this new day, even when you aren't sure. We lift up our heads to meet the day. Get ready for life is all around. We fortify our hearts with compassion and action. If rain still lingers, open the umbrellas of hope and set out anyway. For we are called to dance again.
Let us pray. Holy One, Justice Seeker, Lover of Creation, you set this world in motion and gave it life. Turn us to you when our steps are not sure. Come and dance with us, engage with us as we seek you so that we can be risen with Christ and in Christ. Be with us now, we pray. Amen. The peace of the risen Christ is with you. And also with you, I invite you to turn to the people around you and to wave a sign of graceful greeting on this day, or you can wave at the screen and we'll wave back to you. Our first scripture lesson from this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, starting with chapter 24, verse 36. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then Jesus said to them, "Why are you frightened, and why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. He said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." Our second reading comes from the book of 1 John, chapter 3. "See what love the Holy One has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What do we know? What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure." Here ends this morning's scripture lesson.
Today's lesson from Luke is the story about Jesus appearing to the disciples after Easter. And when they see him, they think he's a ghost. And so he shows them his hands and his feet as a way to assure them and prove to them who he is. The lesson says, while they're in their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. Joy and disbelief. I'm wondering if you've ever had times like that where you've experienced all of your feelings and emotions all at the same time. Joy and disbelief, or faith and doubt, or wondering. Maybe you've been with a loved one who has been very sick and they passed, and you are overwhelmed with grief, and yet you are also somehow relieved that their suffering, and maybe even yours, has also passed. Maybe you've lost a job, and the stress of not having an income is so intense. And yet there's also a part of you that realizes that this job was not fulfilling, and you're wondering if there's more. Or maybe you're facing the end of a relationship, and the thought of that breaks your heart. And yet you also wonder what might fill your heart in a new way. I think life often has times and seasons where all of our feelings and thoughts are kind of in there, not just the good and not just the hard, but they're kind of mixed and woven in there together at the same time. Joy and sorrow, loss and new life, love and heartache. Today, our disciples experience this same brokenness and wholeness in their journey with Christ at the same time. How excited they must have been to see their friend and Savior after he had died, and how exciting that must have been to see him again after they had wept so many tears and wondered what was going on. And yet how scary it must have been to think that what Jesus said was going to happen, this resurrection thing, actually happened. And what was that going to mean for them and for the community? What would their next steps be as friends and disciples? I think in some ways, during this time of COVID, we've also experienced that both and mix of things. I shared a post on Facebook a few weeks ago by Dave Hollis that said, "In the rush and return to normal, use this time to consider which parts of normal are worth rushing back to. Marcia McPhee shares the story about an artist, Elizabeth Turk, who created a film at Mount San Antonio Gardens, which is a senior living facility in California. And she asked the senior adults there, what do you tell yourself when you face adversity? What do you tell yourself when you face adversity? And they wrote their answers on sticky post-it notes, and you'll see some of this in the video clip you're going to see after I'm done. So with the 31-acre facility as her canvas and the 500 residents and staff members as her medium, Turk envisioned this wild garden on steroids as she created this moving art film. It was a project called Project Look Up. Look Up had participants ranging in ages from 64 to 104, and they interacted with each other as they meandered along the shoreline while they viewed the beautiful cliffs that overlooked the sea. And they, while they walked and meandered around, they were using these beautifully crafted umbrellas. One, the artist said, "It just hit my heart. I thought, what better community to engage with to remind us of joy and resilience? Vulnerable people leading us back to joy and togetherness." The Mount San Antonio Gardens executive, Maureen Bythe, said that they were initially hesitant about letting the residents participate because of COVID-19. And then she said, "But because I knew that something positive was sorely needed, I felt it was important for us to go out on a limb a little bit." And so on a crisp November day, masked participants gathered, and each of them carrying a colorful umbrella featuring the artist's drawings of plants, plants that symbolized success in the face of adversity. To make Look Up more inclusive, the artist arranged to photograph residents who had been unable to participate. Those with mobility issues received a mechanism that allowed an umbrella to be attached to their wheelchair or their walker. In the weeks leading up to the event, residents prepared handwritten notes to Ms. Turk and answering her question about adversity with sayings such as, "Be brave," "I am a warrior," and "Breathe." Look Up kicked off at the pool, in and around the water, as a saxophone played soothing jazz and drones buzzed overhead taking pictures, filming the action. And later, dozens of retirees snaked through the community garden to Tchaikovsky's March of the Tin Soldiers. And on the putting green in the golf course, couples danced to Unchained Melody, encircled by 100 residents swaying their umbrellas to create wide shadows on the grass. For the finale, all the participants assembled in the central parking lot, moving in a final interaction before dispersing to Louis Armstrong's What a Wonderful World. Many stayed behind after the filming, umbrellas still open, and not wanting this beautiful and special day to end. Michael Lampkin, who's a resident and a retired music professor, said, called the event a moment of joy and a moment of real celebration. "There's so much division going on in the world, he said. Something like this, where people could be together, people could be united in this project, and people could feel really good about being human for a few moments. That's uplifting." So what would you have told the disciples to guide and encourage them in today's story? How would you have nudge them to take their next steps as followers of Jesus? And how do you embrace the brokenness and the wholeness of life? How do you help guide and encourage each other? How do you face adversity? Our call to worship says, for the disciples, even in their joy of seeing Jesus after the resurrection, they were still disbelieving and wondering. We're reminded that even though we may not know our next steps in life or our next steps during COVID, that we can be sure they will come because we are God's beloved children. And so we have steps to follow, those of Jesus and the Holy Spirit. Here's the trailer, just a portion of the Look Up film. Enjoy.
Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart. Teach me to move in the power of your spirit. Teach me to move in the light of your presence. Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart.
For the beauty of the world and all its diversity, we give you thanks, O God. We are grateful for COVID vaccines, for signs of spring, for new life in you, and for the kindness and generosity of others. Let us pray together. May our gratitude to you fill our days. We need your healing, Holy One, for our troubled planet, for our nation, for all who are struggling in body, mind, relationships, and spirit. We remember those who are suffering, and we pray for Joe, Sharon's family, Gloria, Kay, a brother, Gary, Marianne, Jess, Brett and family, Joyce, Stanley, Jillian, Charles, Linda, Pastor Ritter, Loyon, Dorothy and her family, Sherry, Tom and Beverly, Tandy, Darlene, Edna, Angie and her family, Al, June, Francis, Dorothy, Elaine, Kathy, Richard and Lisa, Catherine, Jane and Katie, Pat, Nancy, Jeff, Jack, Richard, Liz, Leona, Kim and her family, and Tawson. Let us pray together. Come, O God, and restore our lives.
Teach me to pray in the power of Easter, following Christ in the life resurrected. Teach me to act with compassion and justice. Teach me to dance with the beat of your heart.
Be with each of us now. May the dance of your spirit ever call us, re-engage us with you and with the needs around us. Lead us, guide us, surround us, and fill us. Let us pray together. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Teach me to love with your heart of compassion. Teach me to trust in the word of your promise. Teach me to hope in the day of your coming. Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart.
Jesus called his disciples witnesses to the possibility of resurrection. The world is in need of continued resurrection to new life. We are called to be witnesses to this journey of newness, this journey to newness, by offering our resources and our energy to the work of justice and love through our offerings today. We give thanks for the many ways that you support and bless God's mission and ministry.
Thank you.
We have heard the risen Jesus speak peace and offer us hope through his very body. We have danced with dreamers past and present. Send us forth now, O God, to live in the freedom of the peace that you still speak to us, making our steps more sure each and every day. And may the loving God, risen Christ, and dancing Spirit fill you with all you need for the days ahead. And all God's people say, Amen.